Take you to a meeting that you've had with heads of media about things like the reach rules, the 2 out of 3 rule and so on. Is the government, well, it's obviously open-minded, but is the government moving towards changes to these sort of media regulations?
We're certainly looking at them very carefully. The view is put to me by many people in the industry, and I think it's a view that has a... it's very cogent. About ownership rules, and that goes like this. Why in an age where the internet has become the super platform, the hyper platform, to which everyone has access to, and which is increasingly providing more and more and more and more avenues for competition in the media, why do we need to have platform-specific ownership rules dealing with newspapers and radio and television? Because that is an increasingly small part of a smaller part of the media landscape. And so the argument goes to say, look, there is diversity is no longer an issue. Competition is greater than it ever has been. That's undoubtedly true. Why not just leave it media mergers and ownership issues to the ACCC, to the standard, you know, competition monopoly rules that apply
to
the rest of
the industry. And what do you think of that proposition?
I think it's a very. When we make a decision, we'll obviously announce it. But we're looking at it very carefully. I think it is. It makes a very powerful point. You see, Paul, you and I have been involved in the, as in Peter's a mere boy compared to us, but if you go back to the mid-80s when Keating allowed Murdoch to buy the Herald and Weekly Times Group, from that point on, Murdoch had 75 or thereabouts percent, 70% plus, of metropolitan daily newspaper circulation in Australia. And that fact has dominated thinking about the media in Australia. You know, huge domination by News Corp and Rupert Murdoch. Now, what's happened since then is that you've seen the Murdoch share of metropolitan daily newspaper circulation is as high as it ever was. But the share of the total media pie represented by newspapers has got smaller. And this is not... I mean, some newspapers are losing circulation, that's true, but it's really because the rest of the pie has expanded. It's because of pay television, subscription television, and then, of course, the internet and so many other sources of news and information. And you then have to say to yourself, well, why do we have a rule that prevents one of the national networks acquiring 100% coverage? Why is there a 75% reach limitation? Why is there a rule that says today that you can't own print, television and radio in the same market? I mean, shouldn't that, you know, the argument goes, shouldn't that just be a matter for the ACCC? I mean-